Aloha and welcome to a boat story here on Mahalo, our boat. And it's not all fun and games. I know you see us cruising, traveling all the time, but yeah, it's not all like that. Everyone has their problems. Our problem today is the transmission gear cooler. It broke over the winter somehow. The end corroded off and there it is. So today we've got to go replace the transmission cooler on the starboard engine. Follow along. Well, welcome to my engine room. Not a lot of room here. And as you can see, we got started already and got the old one out, which I just showed you. And the new one is in here just to see if it fits. But we have to add the cooling parts to it, to the new unit. And so I'm gonna take it upstairs. It's just gonna be easier to work on. As you can see, this is a really tight space in here. So. Gotta take it out. See if we can get this thing moved out. Alright, let's see if this piece will come out. Like so. Ah, there we go. Alright, let's go take this thing upstairs. That's the new part right here. Alright, so I've made myself comfortable in the salon here. As you can see, the new one comes with two zincs. I don't think the other one had any zincs. That to speak of, these are the two angles we got to put on. It has the grounding bolt right here, and yeah, so let's get these angles on. So the tough part was trying to find this piece that broke off, and that belongs right in here, like so. And of course it broke off, and trying to find a 1/8 with a 3/8 nipple like this is hard to find. This happens to be a quarter, which we found at Lowe's, with a 3/8 barb. And then we went to Napa and we got this one, which is 1/8 male right there with the 1/4 inch female. And we're gonna put that together for this. And we're gonna be using some Forma gasket because it's going to have some, this is actually going to have water through it. That's not a problem. But when you work with these angles right here, which go on the top, they're going to have oil, 30 weight oil on it. And so we didn't want to use any pipe tape on it because it might not hold up for the long term. Forma gas is going to be better for that. So that's our plan right now, is to get these cleaned up, put them in here, and pre-mount them, screw them in so they're fastened and ready to be installed down there. And I'm gonna install this guy right here. Alex is looking for a brush so we can clean the threads off this thing right here. All right, so we're just gonna clean this so that the Forma gasket attaches with no problem. So everything's cleaned. We got these angles right here. That's for the gear oil to go through. What we're gonna do is apply some of this right here and let it dry for a few minutes. And then we're gonna screw them in. That's the plan. While it says to apply it to both sides, it may or may not be possible because these threads, and I'm not gonna spill that right now. I'm just gonna brush it on here and I think we're gonna be just fine. We just brush it and let it dry for a couple minutes, then screw it in. So that's what we plan to do here. Yeah, unfortunately, I don't have too many hands here, but as you can see, we got the gasket on there, still dripping a little bit, and got the nipple on there, so the barb should be all set to go. All right, not sure if you can see, but we're back here at the back of the boat, starboard engine, and there you can see those two screws. There's one right there, there's one there, and that holds down the clamps that are back here that wrap over the top. Those are the two that need to be removed for this to come out. So first we remove the hoses, and the hoses attached here and attached there. Once you got those removed, then you can remove those two from the clamps. Just get a long socket in there. We're gonna do it in reverse. And yeah, that's how that thing came out. I was afraid we're gonna have to take the aftercooler out, but the aftercooler can stay just fine. Now, C-Bar Marine, I believe is what it's called, they said, hey, the fuel cooler that's located right here is not needed on this engine, and you could remove it and actually put that cooler in between here. For me right now, it's too much work to try to rework this thing. It's easier just to reinstall it in the location it was at. And this one plug, by the way, and that's right there, you can see it, the black plug. We just had to unplug that. It just got in the way to work with. All right, so at this point, I'm gonna shove that back in there. And again, I don't have a second hand to hold my camera, but basically we're gonna insert it there and then hook all the water back up. The hose is a little on the dry side for the barb right there. So I'm gonna use the heat gun just to warm it up enough to slide it over, and it should be fine. All right, as you can see, we got the cooler installed here and here. It's time to put the brackets on and then the hoses to make sure all the hoses fit. So I may put the hoses first, and then I'm gonna have to put the brackets on before I can hook up the oil hose though. So, but I can put up the other hoses first. All right, so time to hook up some hoses. All right, one more thing to note is you see this cushion here. It's like a molded cushion that this sits on. Mine is painted, so it has a line there. Just make sure that, I guess, it's in the right location. We're gonna hook up the hoses now. All right, so for the bracket, there's this little screw, and I'm using a magnetic tip to get that in and behind here, as you can see, like that. Again, I gotta have my hand free, so I can't show you exactly as I put it in, but that's my way of doing it, is using a magnetic tip and then screwing it lightly in, and then I can ratchet in the rest of the way. A bit tight in here. You can see I got my headlight on. A bit tight in here. Headlight helps. But I had to feed the first line below this line right here because it gets really tight because this pipe is in the way. And so now we got to hook up this one to this one here. And then the oil lines are connected. After the oil lines, we'll work on the water lines. All right, so we are done. We've got it installed. We got the brackets back on. We got the hose reconnected going up down this way. Got the air filter back on. There's the corner hose right there. So everything is hooked back up. The two oil lines to the gearbox are good and tight. And it looks like we're all good to go. Another project done. Next, gonna figure out what we're gonna do next. All right, I think we're all done. Thank you for watching our boat story here. Mahalo, we'll see you again next time.